salutations at the lotus feet of our beloved Bhagwan, Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Respected elders, sisters and brothers, on behalf of State President of Sri Sathya Sai Seva Organization, Delhi-NCR, Sri Jatindra Chima, and members of the organization, I heartily welcome you all on this auspicious moment. Now, why I say auspicious is that I feel that Swami himself is sitting amongst us and is going to talk to us. Today is a very special day. No words are enough to introduce or welcome, sir. He is an amazingly divine soul, so blessed, so fortunate. When I say a few words of introduction for him, last night when I was writing his introduction, I had tears of joy in my eyes. Because the more you read about him, the more you feel how fortunate he has been and how blessed he was to be with Baba. So, a big round of applause again. We are blessed to have him here. And also, he is accompanied today by his wife, Srimati Vijaya Lakshmi Kamaraju, who has come to Delhi for the first time. So, big round of applause. We'd like to felicitate by giving a bouquet. I request Chimaji to give a bouquet to Professor Anil Kumar ji. Mrs. Amrina Chimaji to give a bouquet to Mrs. Respected Professor Anil Kumar Kamaraju hails from a Brahmo family. His family has been following Brahmo Samaj for three generations. He was born to very well educated and learned parents. His father, Sri Kamaraju Papaya, was MA, MSc Honours, B.Ed, DLSC means Diploma in Library Science, I just confirmed that. And he retired as Regional Joint Director of Public Instruction, Government of Andhra Pradesh. His mother, Mrs. Kamaraju Sarojini Devi, was MA LT, which is equivalent to B.Ed, and who retired as DEO Andhra Pradesh Service. Though Professor Anil Kumar speaks only a few words of Hindi, I've been told, his wife, who is fortunately present here today, as we all saw, was a professor in Hindi. Is that right? Swami has his balancing ways. Sri Anil Kumar himself was postgraduate from Andhra University, Visakhapatnam. He started his career as lecturer in botany, Andhra Christian College, Guntur, 1963 to 89. This is the school he went to for his own undergraduate studies earlier. Before I go on to share his career summary, especially the great work he's been doing for Baba's institutions for decades, I'm sure many of us would like to hear a little about how he met Sri Sathya Sai Baba, or we already know about it. No? You'd like to hear? Great, thank you. Back in the year 1970, an eminent devotee and a great scientist by the name of Dr. Bhagwatam happened to visit the town where Professor Anil Kumar lived. And he gave a talk narrating his experiences with Sai Baba, Sri Sathya Sai Baba, in a most scientific manner, which made a deep impression on him. Later on that year, Professor Anil had some family problems, and so he went to Prasanthi Nilayam to ask Sai Baba for help. In fact, he got to know about Sri Sathya Sai Baba through his wife, Srimati Vijaya Lakshmi Kamaraju. And Google can be deceptive, so sir, please correct me after this. As it has happened to numerous people, especially those Baba has loved dearly, Sri Anil Kumar didn't get a single opportunity to talk to Baba, and as a result, in his own words he says, he experienced 5 very unsuccessful days of togetherness with Baba. Unsuccessful, he was not able to meet Baba. He goes on to say that Baba spoke to almost every person there but him. Yet when he returned home, he discovered that the family problem has been resolved completely magically. After this episode, Professor Anil Kumar started reading Bhagwan's discourse series, Sathya Sai Speaks, with which he became very inspired. As a student, he was always first in elocution and debating contests, he says, but never in academics. In all the elocution competitions and inter-university competition, he always came first. He was also very much interested in public speaking and learning effective communication skills from the very beginning. So having been inspired by Swami's discourses, he started sharing with small groups about them, and then people started inviting him to come and talk to them about Sri Sathya Sai Baba. This went on for 8 years, excuse me, and mind you, he was still not able to meet Baba. For 8 years, he was not able to meet Baba in person yet. He went to see Sai Baba on many occasions, but he ignored him for 8 years, year after year. However, after 8 long years of waiting, in 1977 at Anantapur, Baba finally called on him by his name for the first time. He never looked at him, he called on him by his name. And what is more, he asked him to give a talk in the Purnachandra auditorium, straight away, after 8 years. Ever since, Professor Anil Kumar has been the luckiest man surviving on this planet Earth, as we all know. Isn't that so? Standing side by side with Baba, 23 years, I'm going to come to that. Since then, he has been closely associated with Sri Sathya Sai Educational Institutes and Organization. He was the principal of Sri Sathya Sai University, Bangalore, 1989 to 1995. Professor Biosciences, Sri Sathya Sai University, Prasanthi Nilayam, 95 to 2012. He has also held several organizational positions. He was Zonal Convener, Sri Sathya Sai Organization, Andhra Pradesh from 80 to 84. State Vice President, Sri Sathya Sai Organization, 84 to 85. Jaldi say 84 to 85. And then State President, Sri Sathya Sai Organization, 85 to 89. As we know, Professor Anil Kumar is best known for translating Swami's discourses into English. He has translated Bhagwan's discourses for 23 years. Talks in many science centers about Swami and his teachings. In fact, sharing his experiences has become his passion and full-time occupation after his retirement. He has authored 35 books, which include, and all Baba, of course. 35 books, which include Satya Upanishad, Radiance of Rays, Psychology, very good name, inspired by that name, Psychology. We are all living in that psychology. He has toured spreading Baba's divine messages in almost 50 countries, and there are many, I won't name them here, but almost every country from east to west and north to south, 50 countries. He also contributes articles to Sanatan Sarathi and Sri Vani, and talks every Sunday at Prasanthi Nilayam. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are fortunate.
Yeah. Sainath Baba Maharaj Ku. My humble pranams at the lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan, dear brothers and sisters. I very well remember the inauguration of this international center. I followed Swami on both occasions, and Swami asking me to go around the whole building and insisting me to see every corner of this building, its elevation, its front. I also know how Swami loves Delhi very much. I am also very much sure that you mentioned some of the streets of Delhi in private conversations. I happen to recall those days when Swami visited Delhi, particularly when Sohan Lal was alive in our midst. Swami is speaking that he brought roses from Kashmir all the way. There's a bed of roses making Swami to walk along. That is Delhi the Great. I'm so proud to remember Swami mentioning Sri Murugal Ramakrishnarao, the governor of Punjab, Kerala for a long time, and well versed both in writing and speaking in about 15 languages. So short in stature, but gigantic by virtue of his performance. Swami tells us this way. You know, Ramakrishna came for darshan to Sohan Lal's house. You know where he stood? He stood in line along with others. And Swami, happily, with a glow on his face, goes on to say, I came out to the interview and saw Ramakrishna there. I went there and told him, Ramakrishna, you please go and sit there. You are governor. Why do you stand that way? And Ramakrishna said, Swami, I'm here in the capacity of a devotee, not as a governor. The hallmark of devotion is humility. I also happy to bring back to memory that visit of Bhagwan to Delhi when Parliament was in full session. We find Advaniji and Vajpayee visiting Swami both morning and evening. Both morning and evening. And Sivaraj Patel, all those people. And the most funny thing is, Vajpayee himself asking Anil Kumar ji, when Swami will get down, when he will give darshan, are Vajpayee asking me? Even Boliswara doesn't care you. How his Prime Minister asks you? Only to let you know, my friends, catch hold of feet of Bhagwan, you'll be everything far exceedingly better than everybody all over the world. I know all of them lining up for Bhagwan's darshan. It was also a day when Sivaraj Patilji hosted dinner in honor of the visit of Bhagwan, and the very big shamiana in front on the green lawns. All of us sat there. I didn't have a seat to sit. I was standing. But there are some chairs, special chairs, all past prime ministers, past presidents of this country, sitting there, king of kings, Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Then comes Bhagwan smiling Swami, catching hold of the rope with one hand and moving the other hand into the empty air. With a beautiful, mischievous smile, Swami goes into that residence and the door is half closed. And the people, special invitees, are to go there and sit for the dinner. Sight for gods, the union ministers, cabinet ministers, they were running like primary school children. running because they are not sure of their seats. That divine electromagnetic power, that one she says. You don't find anywhere in the history. I was just wondering and watching. At the end of the dinner, Swami asked me, Anil Kumar, you had dinner. Swami, not necessary. Why? I have seen all these people, Swami, running like that. I thought our college boys only run after you. See, the cabinet minister, yem ledha pa. All are my boys only, whether they are ministers. That is love of Bhagwan for these people. I very well remember. And yes, his visit to, yes, this is very important point. So many VIPs, you see, it's very difficult to say who is a VIP, who is not a VIP in Delhi. Everybody is VIP in Delhi. Very difficult. And Swami had to visit so many residences. He had 5 breakfasts, 10 lunches, 10 dinners. And Swami tells after his return, Yemo inna nappa, akkada chimchati nedi vachedi em I go everywhere. I can't eat more than a spoon, but they want me. But I think you feel sleepy, better you go. It will be 12:30 by the time I return. That is the only occasion, visit of Bhagwan to Delhi. Bhagwan returning back to his residence at 12:30 in the night. That speaks of his love for Delhi. And really, I'm very fortunate to be here among you. I feel that I'm specially blessed. I thank the gentleman who made an elaborate, extensive research into my details and made a kind of presentation. I wish I deserve it. And this day, as President Chima already mentioned to me, coincides with Christmas celebration. Christmas celebration. That's what he told me a moment ago. What is Christmas? How we Sai devotees take it? Why should I deal that topic here when most of you may be expecting something else? My friends, it is Jesus Christ who said, I am the truth, I am the way, I am the life. I am the truth, I am the way, I am the life. Satyam Sivam Sundaram. I am the truth, Satya Sai Baba. I am the way, Dharma. I am the life, the Ananda. Therefore, Jesus Christ's declaration that I am the truth, I am the way of life has all personified God walking in earth on 2 feet amongst us by name Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Jesus is very, he belongs to shepherd. Bhagavan is a cowherd. Jesus is born in a very poor family, Swami hails from a hamlet, tiny hamlet, of 100 population only then. And Jesus was always found in the company of youngsters, boys in particular. We should see Swami how happy he is in the company of boys and children. To make Swami happy, we should always project children and boys in front rows, because he's fed up with we seniors here. because he has very high hopes on them. And Jesus spent most of the time in private conversations, most of them coupled with parables, nice stories. Bhagwan talks chinna katha, full of stories and parables. Bhagwan never gave importance to money, because he said money comes and goes, morality comes and grows. It was Jesus who said, it is easy for the camel to pass through the eye of a needle, not for the rich man to get into the gates of heaven. Bhagavan always cares for your heart. Swami cares for your love. I want your love. I do not want anything more. To give you certain examples, my friends, I'm not tired to repeat any number of times. It was in the year 1988 in Kodaikanal, there's Narayan Seva, around 600 are asked to participate. 600 villages gathered there. Slowly the crowd started increasing, but the food is just made for 600 people only. Mrs. Ratanlal asked me to go over to the kitchen. I went there, Ma, what do you want? Please inform Swami, their food stuff is exhausted. No more of food. He's inviting everybody, where am I to be now? Please tell him. That being the first year of my service, I ventured and ran and tried to represent to Swami. Later period, unthinkable. The first year of service with Swami is a honeymoon period. That will be given a wide margin and your mistakes will be tolerated, if not excused. But a later time, slightest mistake, the risk of life. Risk of life. And once anything goes wrong, well, he'll give you double, triple, multiple dose in front of everybody so that you don't repeat the same mistake for several lives to come. That is Bhagwan. Somehow when Mrs. Ratanlal told me, I went slowly to Swami and said, Swami, him. Swami, food is exhausted. Him? When he doesn't want to hear, he'll ask you to say again. Particularly. So that you are made to commit twice. Swami, food is over. Huh? What nonsense you are speaking. Ledu kadu anedi sai jeevitamlo ledu gurtu pettuko. There's nothing like stuff exhausted. Never say it is over. Never say no. That's not there in the dictionary of Baba. You know that? Go back inside. I ran back. Went away straight to the kitchen. By that time, doors are already closed. Since Swami said, go back. So I went and opened the doors. I'm highly conscious of the fact that I'm speaking in the presence of Bhagavan. And I said this many times. This is recorded in my books. And also in my recent talk at Prasanthalayam on 21st. By the time I opened, what happened? All empty, big utensils, they are full of rice and sambar. That is Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba, full. I reminded of Jesus Christ, who attended a wedding at a place by name Kana. Around 500 people are expected. Jesus Christ is always followed by number of disciples as Bhagavan is. You cannot invite him to come alone, sit and go, you can't do that. Number of people will follow. 5,000 people followed Jesus Christ to Cana to attend that wedding. Well, the hosts are finished. What are we to do? And Jesus went near them and said, what's the problem? Swami, that is the problem. He went inside. The holy text, holy Bible records this. Jesus Christ lays both of his hands on empty drums, empty containers. They're full of fish and wine. Full of food, enough for 5,000 people. That is Sathya Sai Baba. That is Sathya Sai. Jesus Christ was just passing by. The number of devotees and the disciples who are seated, and suddenly there is seated a very elderly man who is totally blind. Oh my Lord, I can't see. Oh my Lord, I am blind. What am I to do? We find Jesus Christ just keeping his palm on both his eyes, the vision restored. Then he shouted, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Similar thing happened in the life of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. There is a place about 30 miles from my native place. His son is doing Seva duty right now. His father, 80 years old, totally blind. And Swami gave him interview. We have eyes, we can see, he doesn't grant interview. He grant interview to those blind fellows, what to do? That is the divine romance, we can't help it. And he called him and looked at the son, what's wrong with your father? Swami, he can't see, he's totally blind. Then Swami said, you are responsible. You are not shouldering equal responsibility of your dad. You have gone into the politics. You are neglecting the whole family. This is not the way. But your father has been my devotee since long. If you make a promise that you look after the business, I'll help your dad. Then this fellow kept his hand on the hand of Swami. This is promise, Swami. Swami said, Aunra, meer promise chesi miss chestarra. You make a promise and you miss that promise. But I never miss that. Then Swami came close to him, kept his palm on the eyes of this old man. There he shouted in the interview room, Jai Sai Ram, Jai Sai Ram, Jai Sai Ram. And the guy he recorded in books also. Is there in the Holy Bible, the lame could walk, the blind could see? Yes. When I was in Whitefield, I saw a lady who requires at least two wheelchairs to sit. Papa, very heavy personality. But somehow she was dumped in a wheelchair, packed there. And two or three people had to push. I was seeing all that. She has gone in the entry room. Lo and behold, subject to verification, this is there in Sanatana Sarade. By the time interview is over, we find that lady walking normally. The lady could walk. That is Sathya Sai Baba. He saw me from a long distance. Come on, what are you looking at? Swami, I am seeing her. You have come to see me or her? What nonsense you are doing? Swami, I see her. She is Irish lady. She has been suffering from arthritis for the last 35 years. She can't walk. Now you see her walking. It is normal for Swami. Maybe abnormal to you. It is usual and casual to Swami. But it may be exceptional to you. Baba said it. This I am a direct witness to what had happened there at Prashantanilaya. Jesus said, rejoice, rejoice. Christmas is a celebration to rejoice. Christmas is a celebration full of festivity and gaiety and joy. To wear a long and serious Shakespearean face on Christmas occasion is treacherous to the whole festival. The purpose and the mission of festival is gone. Jesus wants us to enjoy, to rejoice, to be joyful. So this Christmas means that we should be joyful. We should sing His glory. We should be very grateful to Him. I also remember another incident at the time of International Cardiothoracic Surgeons. Many doctors from all over the world attended the conference to make their own presentations. I translated Swami's inaugural address. Second day also I translated His valedictory address. On the second day valedictory address, one or two doctors are picked to speak on their own experiences in the conference. One doctor from Italy is picked up. He is asked to speak on the dais. I repeat, what did he say? I am from Italy. I am attached to the Pope. I am known all over the country. I am a Catholic. As a Catholic, we have got the discipline to pray to our Lord thrice or four times. Yesterday evening, at the end of the conference, I have gone back to my room, bolted the door from inside. While kneeling, I was praying to Lord Jesus. While I'm in prayer, suddenly I noticed some hand on my shoulder. I turned back. I noticed Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Then I asked him, Swami, how is that you are here? I bolted the door. And Baba tells him, nuts and bolts na napali ora. Nuts and bolts cannot stop me. What do you mean? This he narrated in front of Swami. This he said it. Hearing this, I could not control my emotion. Immediately after the conference, Swami went back to his room, Purnachandra Auditorium. At that time he was staying. I went there straight. I don't know what type of fool I am. I opened the door all myself. Swami sat there. Here, what happened? What happened? Some emergency call or what? Swami, what happened? I heard that Italian doctor telling that you are Jesus, that you are cosmic Christ, that you are second coming of Christ. Swami, I could not control myself, therefore I came. You know what Baba said? Being with me, you want that fellow to certify. You want that fellow to certify. This is the tragedy with you fellows here. He took it in a casual way. But I was so happy to report to Swami what happened. And they had, in foreigner's canteen, the lunch and the dinner for these doctors. And I went there. Swami came and said, why are you here? You are not a doctor. Swami, I'm not a doctor, I know. He said, why are you here? Swami, how the dinner is, how these people relished, somebody should report to you. Therefore, I'm here. All right, stay here, throw out and tell me. Some of my friends, he gave me many, many chances all these 23 years to be close to him, to joke with him, and took liberties also. I wonder how he could tolerate me. I am not able to reconcile how could bear with me, how he could bear with me. Anil Kumar, come here, he would say that. I'll say something to make something lighter. All the boys on the last day of his stay in Kodaikana, they were all crying, Hamsotunke, Tyari Ketana. The tragic songs are there. Naya Sagara, Karna Kara. I don't know why the people sing like that. You can please sing at home, you cry, make others cry, but not in public. In public, make everybody laugh, everybody energetic, enthusiastic, so that everybody could follow. This is not a music concert. And so the fellow, and the Swami said, bus, enough is enough. Are why are you crying? Swami, we have to go tomorrow. Who asked you to go? You stay here, I'll go. Swami, you should know, I've got college, schools, admissions, so many responsibilities there. How can I be here since you have no other work? Stay here as long as you are. That's what he said. Then the fellows are raising. Anil Kumar, come here. See, the fellows are like that. Though they have been with me for the last 1 month, still they want to be here. What is to be done? Swami, it's not their mistake. Your company is such Madhura Adipate, Akhila Madhura, where it will never be quenched for a lifetime. It is sweet, sweeter and sweeter day by day. I can understand. I'm sorry. Say something to make everybody happy. Then I said, Swami, I take some liberty. You should excuse me, extra liberty. You should excuse me. It is usual for you. Come on, say, I'm not asking. Then I said, Swami, you repeatedly, emphatically say that you are God, you are God. I'm not able to believe that I'm God. I don't think I'm God. I'm not able to believe. Then Baba said, all right, you are not God. Oh, you are a buffalo, okay? Everybody laughed like you. And then he said, come on, carry on, carry on, carry on. All right, Swami, since you say I am God, my name now onwards is Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. I am God Sathya Baba. Swami is looking like that. What happened to this fellow? As God, I am supposed to have only a half glass of water in the morning, 3:30, 4 o'clock. Start, get ready by 6:30 and start giving darshan. It is impossible for me to get satisfied with half glass of water. Impossible. Impossible. I'll have three rounds of coffee by the time I come for darshan. Impossible. So I must enjoy. And then I start giving darshan. As Baba, I give darshan. And then few police fellows unnecessarily follow me in the name of security. And they give me security. I'm here to assure security to all of you. Who are they fellows? No. But police fellows also want Padma Namaskar. They push you so that they will have Padma Namaskar. And then Swami comes forward. And then what happens? He goes towards the lady's side first. Lady's side. Towards the lady's side. Believe me, I told in the presence of Swami, and it is recorded in the books. Yes. Literally true. And so on, it goes first ladies' row. Who are seated in the front row? Those who sit for the last 50 years, or at least 60 years, will never give an opportunity any fresher, any newcomer. And they think, this is my seat. I don't know whether they were transported to the other planet with that seat. They don't give. Suppose if any lady comes and says, Swami, Amma, my husband is in serious condition. Would you have a mission? It's my seat, go ahead. I must catch flight by 10 o'clock. This sight of ladies I have to see every day. Ibandanadi, this lab is mine. According to scriptures, we take birth of that in which we are interested. So if you are interested in the slab on which you sit, next life you are going to born as a slab. Kalapa slab, the stone. Swami looks at those people and then slowly comes towards the gent side. Seniors are there. What do they write? Swami, cataract, when should I have? Joint pains, when I get relief? When are you going to name my great-granddaughter? Nobody will say, Swami, thank you that you have taken care of us till now. We are happy, hale and healthy by your grace, Swami. The whole family is doing fine. No letter of thanks, no letter of gratitude. Always, Swami, when my son-in-law is going to get promotion, when my grandson will get visa, when my daughter would get married without dowry, when my son would get married with a double dowry. These are the letters. I have to receive them as such, Baba, what to do? Then look at those people, then come towards VIPs. What do they write? Swami, you may not look at me, but don't look at Anil Kumar. You may not keep me in position, but see that he's kicked out of his position. These are the letters from V. All complaint letters I have received. Then silently go and sit there, bhajans. Bhagavan always wishes fast songs, fast, full of joy. But boys don't do that. Suddenly they make it into music academy. long, dragging, plastic, elastic songs. That he's tired of them. Sometimes he would say, are you singers or singers? Yes, I'm a witness to that. So they continue to do the same thing. And then, I want at Sathya Baba, the bhajan singers to sing one Sarvadharma bhajan, because Sai devotees are from different religions. They don't do that. So I have to listen to the same bhajans. And then go for lunch. I don't eat alone. I invite some Central Trust members also to join me for lunch at 9:30 a.m. after the bhajan session. Lunch or dinner with Swami, royal banquet. Not less than 25 items. All will be served. Sathya Sai Baba eats only 2 spoonsful of ragi, finger millet, ragi malt, that's all. Swami, as Sathya Sai Baba, doesn't matter even if I'm God or not, I cannot tolerate others eating when I am not eating. I arrange the lunch for them, they eat like that, and I have to eat just 2 spoons. No. I cannot do that. Then after that, go back to the room with bags of letters, which I got to read, and same thing continues every day, Swami. Life as God, Sathya Sai Baba, is too tiring. I am very comfortable as a human being. I can eat well. I can eat ice creams. I can joke with people. I can talk to people. Sing your glory. I am very happy as a human being. Leave me alone. I am not in a hurry to become there. I am not in a hurry. Swami laughed and laughed. Then the whole atmosphere now brought back to a lighter vein. Why I am telling you, Swami also needs some kind of laughter. If you go and say, Swami, you are God, you are all knowing, you are omniscient. Whether you say or not, God is God. I'm going to give certificate to him. Make him laugh, make him smile. Say thanks to him. Why can't we say that? Why can't we say that? Somehow, we are very much bothered. And then this also I forgot to mention. I call some devotees for interview as Bhagavan Sathya Sai Baba. They get into the interview room. As Baba, I'm interested to pass on some spiritual message. Take the earliest opportunity to pass on the spiritual message. None of them are interested. They carry letters in their pocket. When to give that letter? When to give that letter? So I had to stop my talk, give them some vibhuti, you may go fine. So I am not able to fulfill my task as an incarnation. I am not able to satisfy my devotees because of their endless desires. Swami, please allow me to remain a human being, that's all. I am very, very happy, very comfortable as a human being. Swami enjoyed very much. He wanted me to repeat again. Swami also loves fun. He likes to enjoy. He likes to laugh. He likes to laugh hilariously. You know the pillars there in Kulwant Hall, pillars, huge pillars. Somehow Swami was upset with boys. Any slightest mistake will upset him. So he was avoiding boys. When the pillar is like that, he used to pass this side, not that way, so that he doesn't have to see students. Boys came and said, sir, this is the situation, you should help us. Okay, Ra, let us see. Swami, hey, Anil Kumar, what news? Swami, I have one point. What? In response to the prayers of Prahalada, Lord Narasimha broke the pillar and came out. In response to our prayers, God from outside is getting into the pillar. Swami, that is not correct. Then started normal dialogue. He started talking to everybody. That's what it is. My job is that to keep Swami happy, to the best of my knowledge. Subject to verification, all people that know me know this fact. I never wrote a single letter to Swami. I never asked for any favor. I never made any complaint. If you think Anil Kumar is close to Swami, successful all these years, it is because of this non-complaining attitude. Non-complaining, nothing. After all, good or bad that come to you, depending upon our own prarabdha, depending upon our karma, there is no point in that. Why should I waste divine time by speaking all this? That is, Swami, I am very happy to recall those things, that Bhagavan, his love. You see, I come from a very, very hot place, Guntur, only one climate. Hot, hotter, hottest. That's all. Hot wind should blow this side, it should come out that side. But we feel very comfortable, totally air conditioned, having been born and brought up there. Ooty, First visit, I went there with Swami. Swami said, "Ayyo, you're feeling cold. Ayyo." And a boy, bring him some sweater. He has some sweater. Still hot sweater. Ah, still. Come on. I'll show you where your room is. He took me to his room. Come on. Okay, Swami. Lie down. Come on. This is the blanket. Come on. How are you? Still. Alright, this is not enough. I'll give another blanket. How are you? Okay. No, no. We keep some heater here. Get the heater. Then after 10 minutes, Swami comes back again with a biscuit-colored shawl on which there is a picture of deer and a big tree. This is my personal shawl, yeah? I'm giving it to you. Come on. And he says, good night, dear. That is Sat Seva. To my knowledge, I can say, తల్లి కంటే మిగుల దైవమే ఎక్కువ తండ్రి కంటెను సన్నిహితుడు చాలా అట్టి దైవంబు మరువ అంటును పాపంబు అట్టి దైవంబు మరువ అంటును పాపంబు సత్యమైన మాట ఏ సాయి మాట వాట్ యు సే The one who loves you more than your own mother, the one who is closer to you more than your father, should not be forgotten in your lifetime. It is worse to the sins if you forget God. That's what Bhagavan said. I have not noticed that sort of love, that heights of love that Bhagavan had. Really marvelous, marvelous, unimaginable, unimaginable. He distributes cameras. Japanese cameras brought from Hira, Japan. Very costly cameras. Costly camera, one. Anil Kumar, all got it? Yes, Swami. Chichi. No, all didn't get it. Swami, all 35 boys got it? No. Those drivers didn't get it. Call them. He gave them those cameras. All got it? Yes. No. Two cooks there inside, they didn't get it. That is such a sad part. All equal to him. No one is greater than anybody. If you have got this kind of distinction based on cadre, if you are kind, this kind of differentiation based on the silly conditions, we cannot call ourselves worthy of Bhagavan Sri Sai Baba. Impossible, because he loves all. Unconditional love. While just going in his car, he starts around 6 o'clock in the morning, and reaches Kodaikanal around 6 o'clock in the evening, 12 hours travel. But there in the van, with 35 students, there were so many tins of laddus, jangris, all sweets, tins, and fruits full, all will be over by 6 o'clock finished. Besides that, he stops at different places, they'll have again breakfast, lunch, everything, and that stock also will be over. The fact of facts is, Swami will never have a sip of water. I never saw him to refresh. I never saw him getting into a restroom. Bhagavan at 6 o'clock in the evening is as fresh as 6 o'clock in the morning. That is Sat Sai Baba. Whereas all the rest of us, for every one of us, we should have a wash and apply face powder. Still it's oily, pakka boring face. But Swami is not like that. And then as the car speeds ahead, suddenly he'll ask him, "Arey, stop the car." They'll stop the car. Why? We don't know. There'll be one lady who will be carrying firewood on her head. A villager, very poor. Call her, she comes. And Anil Kumar opened it. There'll be wallet there, I open. Give her one note. 500 rupees, just like that. I was wondering, we don't give 500 just like that. Unless we get 1,000 back, we don't get 500. And then that lady accepts she was going. She doesn't know Bhagavan Baba. She never met him. But I'm there too prompt. Swami noticed, if you do it again, I'll ask you to get down. If you do it again, I'll ask you to get down. And Baba said, mark this statement. Swami needs no publicity, no propaganda. Swami's love, love is Swami. That's all. That's all. Nothing like that. That's what I have witnessed. And then, as we go further, we saw a man with coconut. And then he stood in the center of the road, offered to Swami, coconut water. Swami said, give it to him. He wanted me to drink it. It is meant for him. You have it. So it's a divine order. Okay. Give him one. 500. I never drank any coconut of 500. I don't think so. Anyway. Swami, 500. For coconut? Correct. When I am giving my money, why do you cry? Why? You mean I am buying? No. It is my grace. The man has been praying for me. Therefore I blessed him. That is Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. I also remember, you know, that thatched hats with palmyra leaves they make. While going in his car, Swami stopped, calls one boy. Are how many hats? How many? Swami, 25. What is the cost? Swami, 20 rupees. Put all the hats in the dicky. He gives them 1,000 rupees. Swami, hey, don't be calculated. And then Swami said, these boys, by selling these hats, earn some money to maintain their poor parents at home, who are sick, who are aged. They depend on their earnings. Therefore, who will look after them? Anadha Nehadha, Dina Nadha, Sathya Sai Nadha. That's what I have seen. And then he returns back, calls one boy after another, I put his hat. Come on, photo with. Every fellow with a hat will have photo. Then my turn came. He said, you don't wear the cap. I'll put the cap on you. He kept the cap on my head. That cap trapped me in the divine trap for a lifetime. That's really very, very interesting how considerate he is, how considerate. On the penultimate day, Swami called two servant maids who washed the utensils and sweep the flooring and all that. Gave them silk saris worth about 20,000 rupees. And then cash 20,000 rupees. He asked me to give what? I know how, what is contained there because the amount is written there. And what are you staring at? Swami, 20,000 saris to servant maids, what do they do? They too attend weddings. They too have special functions. They wear these saris and say, Sai Baba gave me this sari. Sai Baba gave me this sari. That's why I have given them this sari. And the 20,000 just a gift. There is other regular salary, regular emoluments, they get it. This is only as a gift Swami's visit to this place. Wow, wow, wow. Unforgettable moments of joy. They are historic, momentous occasions. While there near the garden, beautiful garden there, roses and all that. Every fellow started having photo with Swami. When I came, I wanted to be very close to him. Touch his shoulder. He said, hey, rose flower is there which is more beautiful than you. Keep a distance. And then tells me that rose plant is also praying for me. That also should be clicked in the camera. Why do you want to interfere between me and the devotee, the rose plant? That is Sathya Sai Baba. That is that his love is beyond all measure. The recipients, those that have witnessed these things, will certainly know. But every devotee from everywhere, all over the world, may have direct experience or indirect experience. Everyone has an experience. Experience is experience. That experiential knowledge, that existential, experiential, experimental knowledge will be transmuted into the other world, transformed into bhakti, what we call devotion. That is happening all over the world today. Really, wonder of wonder of wonders. Wonder how things have been happening. There's one doctor by name Hayakawa from Tokyo, Japan. He's a Buddhist. He came to see Swami. Mr. Sonam of Prasanthanam was the student at that time. He narrated this incident on the dais in front of Swami. Why should I tell these references? Doubting Thomases will be there. This Christmas day, I should take into consideration those Dr. Thomases also doctorate in doubts. So let them take it. So, that Hayakawa came for Swami's darshan. Narrated his experience like this. When Hayakawa was planning to come over here, somebody gave him some vibhuti packet. Then that fellow has no idea of vibhuti. What ash? Because those fellows know only cash and trash. They don't know sacred ash, you know. How to explain here? He said, don't worry, brother. When you are in helpless condition, keep that on your tongue. Problem will be solved. Okay. He sat there. And one lady with three of her children, one there, this fellow seated at the center. And the baby, well, naturally, the baby is free, unmindful of the man, status of the man behind, started spoiling his clothes. Completely awful. He could not help the situation. There, London Bridge, top over London, he got down. Who will help me now? Then he kept the vibhuti. Immediately, loudspeakers. Yes, announcement, Dr. Hayakawa wanted at the counter. Dr. Hayakawa. He goes to the counter. And there, Japanese lady sits there. Are you Dr. Hayakawa? Yes. Your seat is transferred to VIP, first seat. First class. No more here. You are shifted there. And that man said, I don't have enough of money to pay for it. It is already paid. Who paid? By an old man. Don't worry, you go and shift. Business class. That is Sathya Baba. Just vibhuti, hari om, gone. All problems gone. I can give you any number of examples of this kind. And that Hayakawa, a rich Puttaparthi and a physicist from Tokyo University. And Swami gave him an interview and said, look here, Hayakawa, your heart has three chambers. Heart should have four chambers. He thought Baba has no formal education. So he must have got confused with three chambers. There are four. No, Swami, everyone should have four. You have only three, right? This is known to your mother and also doctor on duty, no one else. I see. He did namaskar, came out of the entry room. Immediately make a phone call to his mother. Mom, is it true that I have only three chambers? Are who told you? Tell me, is it three or... Yes. No one knows. If anyone told you, it cannot be none other than God. This is what he said in front of Swami. I also remember another man from Arizona University. He came here, India. He wanted to visit all ashrams, all these people. It was the time when Kirlian photography was new. Dr. Baroniski, it was newly introduced, Kirlian photography. He came here with that photograph, you'll find the aura. And that aura will tell you what sort of a man you are. Well, he went there. And he came to Vodavarthi. When he clicked the camera, he could not get anything. All blue color, all pink color like that. Then Swami asked him to speak that evening in the summer course. Dr. Varanasi said, at the risk of my reputation as a scientist, I openly declare Sathya Sai Baba is God on earth today moving amongst us. Why? Because I take my camera of all masters in India across the country. Whether they wanted to click the camera, Bhagavan, photograph, full of pink color. Pink is a symbol of love. Love he is sending forth. Love he receives. Love is my form. Love is my form. That is Bhagavan, she said, say Baba. That's what Varanasi said. I also very well remember just a break. Jai Jai Prabhu Giri Dhalai Nanda Varananda Lala. Suffering from problem. Oh Lord, bless me. I'm not able to bear this pain. She could not touch the feet of Jesus. She could just touch his garment, that's all. By touching his garment, that lady got total relief. Similar thing had happened. A professor by name Banerjee, chemistry department of Calcutta University, happened to visit Prashanth Nilayam because of nagging at home by his wife. Most of Sai devotees are nagged sufficiently by their wives. Therefore, men are here. The men should be highly grateful to their wives. Certainly. I'm not proud of that fact. What to do? It has been called a spade a spade. When once a woman is convinced, she will not leave you, that's all. So she went on nagging at home. And this man said, okay, I'll come there. But I shall not stay there for 24 hours. She said, okay, the lady knows how to manage the husband, particularly the troublesome one. He said, okay. By the time he sat there, train, the Indian trains, you know, some of the windows are loose. That iron window fell on his little finger. Made it a chutney almost. Then he put some wet cloth, very highly painful. He reached Puttaparthi. On the way, he went on praising his wife because of the biggest son of his father. And the man jumped, managed to sit in the front row. Man, this is recorded. He sat in the front row. Then Swami is passing by. He said, Swami, Swami. Swami didn't look back. He stretched his hand. and he just touched his garment. Pain gone, pain gone. That's what it says. It's clearly written in the Holy Bible. Thou hast touched thy garment. Thou hast touched the hem of thy garment. Not in the garment for that matter. You have touched the hem of thy garment. That gives total relief. And I also know Jesus comes close to the Lazarus, who is declared dead. Oh Lazarus, says Jesus, Lazarus is brought back to life. Lazarus rose to life. From the dead, rose from the dead. Is brought back to life. That's recorded in the Holy Bible. There's one devotee of Kuppam. He came to Prachandalayam. They said, Swami, I want to celebrate my 60th birthday at Prachandalayam. Please come. That man came with busload of devotees. Swami left for Bangalore. This man is there. What is to be done? But he didn't stop there. That night that man died. 60th birthday. That has become his death day. Just like that. And then they were crying, all busload of people. And Swami comes next morning. Looks at that lady. How is your husband? How is it? Swami. He needs some coffee, get it. Swami, is there time to joke? He passed away last night. Do you want me to give him coffee? Get coffee. He brought hot coffee there. Radha Krishna, get up. Radha Krishna, get up. Chikkar! And have the coffee. Lazarus rose from the dead. Radha Krishna said he rose from the dead. That's what we find today. And not only that, couple from Los Angeles, United States of America, attended conference there at Madras. And the old couple had been attending, and the husband got some heart problem. He was admitted to hospital. And heart problem, heart patients will be nice enough until they are gone. Because the immune system is fine. Suddenly it stops, that's the problem. So they look, their bodies look so fresh. This man collapsed, finished. And doctors gave death certificate. The body is kept in the coffin to be transported to California, L.A., U.S. This lady wanted to take leave from Swami. She ran to that place. Swami, Swami, what? Swami is no more. What? He is no more. As I told you, when he wants you to say again, he is very keen to make you commit. What? Let me see. Swami went to the hospital. The body was packed, ready to be transported. And Swami said, get up, Kovan, get up. He got up. That is Walter Kovan of California, Los Angeles, United States. I am the truth. I am the way. I am the life. He is the life. You are not the life. He is the giver of the life. He is the life. Amrutasya Traha. Amrutasya Putra is the very life. That's what we have got to understand. It is Jesus Christ, he said, I'll come again, I'll come again. I'll come again. Don't cry, I'll come again, don't cry. It applies very much today. Let us not cry for the physical absence of Swami. Certainly not. Swami is beyond the body. Swami is beyond the body. It's no occasion, no reason to cry. No. Because he said, don't cry. I'll come again. When does he come? He comes whenever you pray. He comes whenever you do bhajans. Wherever you do service, there is Bhagavan, Sri Sathya Baba. There's no doubt. He installs himself wherever his work is done. My friends, I can go on and on. But I know this is severe winter. I have been told that I should try to limit myself so that you can comfortably return home, as tomorrow happens to be a working day. But be that as it may, I want to bring certain facts to your attention, my friends. Why should we go to Puttaparthi? Swami is not there. Say foolish fellows, number one, first order. Somebody asked me, Swami is not there, what do you comment? I tell them, are you here or not? Why do you ask me, I am here? Swami said, I mean you. So long you are there, Swami is there, understand it. So long you are there. Never say Swami is not there. When you are not there, please talk to me that. It's not so. We should never say Swami is not there, because he is everywhere. Point two, Tirupati may be Kshetra of Lord Venkateshwara. Shirdi may be the center, the Samadhi of Shirdi Maharaj, Kashi Kshetra. But Venkateshwara is present all over the world. Kashi Vishwanatha is present everywhere, but still we go to Tirupati. Why? Venkateshwara is here, come on. You have your head neatly shaven, I don't mind. Why do you go there? Why? Same is the reason why you should go to Puttaparthi. What? Because that is Kshetra. Bhagwan Sri Sathya Baba is a Kshetra Palaka. He is a Kshetra Palaka. He is the head of that Kshetra. Therefore, I go to Shirdi, bow down to Samadhi. Yes, I get vibrations. I go to Puttaparthi, bow down to Divya Mahasamadhi, I get divine blessings. Therefore, we need to go as many times as possible before it is too late. Absolutely essential. The next point, this age, we find everyone having a cell phone. With the help of mobile, you can talk to anybody from anywhere. Anywhere. Yes, you are free. But sometimes you cannot talk. Why? Charge gone. All right, cell phone is there, come on, talk. Charger. So what should you do? Come on, charger, charger. One cell needs a charger. Millions of cells in the human body needs a divine charger. Prashanti Janani. We also hear of projects like Bhakranangal project, the thermal stations, Nagarjuna Sagar project, and these are the centers from which the electricity is dispersed and electricity is supplied to different states. But thermal project is the head. If something happens to grid, I can't help you. If something goes wrong at the thermal station, none can help you. Thermal station is electricity generator. Prashantilayam, spiritual energy generator. That's what it is. We should understand that a spiritual energy generator, it is a comforter. Well, in Gaya, what do you have? Mahasamadhi. Shirdi, Mahasamadhi. Every masjid, Samadhi. Yes. What do you find in Palestine? What do you find in Jerusalem? Just a cross. What do you find in Mecca? Only a wall. Why do you go there? Yes, if you go, you will understand it. Similarly, you may not find outwardly, you may deny that nothing would ever happen. Go there, then you will understand. There are many people that they feel that Swami is calling them. There are many people that feel Swami is advising them. Swami is touching them. That's what, for that purpose, my friends, let me appeal, those of the people who feel that Swami is not there, I can pray at home, all right, pray at home, live there and finish off life at home. No, my friends, you are not to be there at home. You are not an individual. You are cosmic, you are cosmic. You are not an individual, but you are universal if you are in constant touch with Bhagavan, Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Individual is raised to the universal level. The water drop becomes an ocean by experiencing Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. All the more there is every need. And Bhagavan clearly said, you may have number of yajnas. Now there are some people say, oh, I repeat so many mantras, please repeat until your throat is gone. Until neighbors complain, that's a big nuisance to us. You may learn all that to experience Bhagavan. Sarve Sathya Sai Service Airline, direct flight to his feet, direct flight to his feet. You don't need to change over. Service is the only way to take you to Swami. Wherever you serve him, Swami is there. Those people that serve, they experience. There's one man right now there, working in stores in Prasanthani. He was Seva, the convener at that time. There, at one place by name, Virukonda. Well, he made all the arrangements till 12 o'clock. Then he got sleep. He couldn't get up. The first bus is at 5 o'clock. He slept at 12, first bus at 5. Well, he was snoring. What to do? Very much tired. Suddenly, Bhagavan sits by his bedside. At 4:30, you are the convener, you are here, come on, get up. First bus at 5 o'clock, come on, go. This time today, you have got the medical camp. That is Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. He will guide you, he will take you, he will show the source, and he will make you do what he decided. My friends, I can tell you what he said. You may forget me, I shall never forget you. You may stop serving me, but I shall not leave you until I accomplish what I really want to accomplish through you. He will never leave you. That is Bhagwan Sri Sathya Baba. I also know there is one service camp at a place by name Bapatla. They arranged a pakka camp there. That morning headmaster comes and says, you cannot have camp here because this school belongs to Ramakrishna Mission. All doctors came there. Patients assembled. Headmaster says you cannot. At that time, helplessly, the president of Sai Center goes inside. On the headmaster's table, there is a calendar, table calendar, where it's written, with blessings, such as Sai Baba. Wife, children, everybody are blessed. That is wholesale grace, but not retail business. Whole family is blessed. Whole family is blessed. Whole family is blessed. Therefore, better we participate in service. Service most important. Better we make visits to Prasanthani. And thirdly, it is very necessary to send our children to Bhava class. Some educational activity. You may wonder why. Don't send them, keep them at home until they drive us out of home. Yes, it's happening today. No child is grateful to his parents today. Take it from me. Whereas such a size system of education, SSE they say, abroad, or education human values here, whatever may be, the first lesson they are taught is, respect your parents, please your parents, that's the first lesson taught to them. We spend all our money, we spend all our resources, all our energy for our children. They simply forget. They simply forget. Remain ungrateful. Not that we want them to be, but they lost the human value. If we want our children to be grateful, if we want our children to be respectful to the members of the community, to the elders, and if we want our children to follow the tradition of our country, we should send them to Bala Vikas, or else hopeless fellows number one. They may get ranks, but they will be blanks in life. They'll be blanks in life. Therefore, I want them to be responsible citizens of this country. Parama Pavanamainati Bharata Vaniyandu Sahanaman Nadimanaku Chakadanamu Prathamulanitiyandu Vanaganchinati Gana Sachasilame Kathina tapamu Madhura bhavam vedi Manadesha mandanna Matru bhavam bukanna manyamedi Pranam bukante Manam bukhanamanu manadesha neetini mantagalipi Nediki chiri Nesa svechayanu vitsukattulavra Yemandu Bharata Palanambu Yemandu Bharata Palanambu Sadhu Sadguna Ganyula Sabhyulara. This is Swami's composition. This is the country which is the land of chastity. This is the country where the truth is held in highest of the esteem, the pride of the country. Satya Nasti Paramo Dharma, Satya Meva Jayate. This is the country where character is valued and you cannot spoil it. What am I to say about the present plight of this country, says Bhagavan in his own composition. So if we want our children to be worthy of this nation, to be worthy of our families, we should send them to such a education program wherever it is available. We have grown-up boys, college students, professionals who just joined service. What do? They prefer cell phone instead of breath. They may miss the breath, but they don't want to miss the cell phone. Other than the cell phone, no avocation, no avocation. What is to be done, my friends? Tomorrow, when I want him, he may say, Dad, wait, I have got some message. Let me read and see you. My friends, there is no direction in life to youngsters. Let them teach them the art of living. I should say, let them teach them the art of life, not living. Because many people live, it's not that. Art of life. To live life well. To live life meaningfully. To lead life fruitfully. Enjoyably. With a particular aim and purpose. Yes, we should send our youngsters to Sri Sathya Sai Seva Dal service activities. When they learn to serve, when you understand the pain of other man, you will know what it is. In fact, I should tell you, while serving others, you get greater joy than serving yourself. When do some service sacrifice, you'll get supreme satisfaction than what you get out of tinsels and trash. Send our children, our boys, youngsters to service activities because we want to calculate everything in terms of sums of coin. There are many people who got their jobs by attending service activities immediately. So those of you who want jobs, come on, service opportunity. You don't need any bloody recommendation of any man. It's an insult to fall flat at the feet of man. Better we pray to God. Better we serve him so that he will serve you. Because Baba said, I have come to serve you and not to be served. Jesus said, I have come to serve you, not to be served. So let us serve, please. And the next comes the senior citizens, we elders. What we do at home, we think about our grandson, how much money he is saving every month. And your life is exhausted. Even if your grandson is a millionaire, what is going to happen with half foot in the grave? Where is he saving? What is the bank interest? Stop that. Less luggage, more comfort, make travel a pleasure. By the time we get them married, there ends the matter, that's all. It's their duty to take care of. If they ask you, come on. Advice readily available. Advice, when it is sought, very essential. Advice given without being asked is interference. Let's not interfere. As adults, let's study Sai literature. Let us speak about Sai literature. Let us know who am I. Let us contemplate. Let us meditate. Let us rejoice in singing and make this life really sweet and so beautiful. Because we know many of the elderly people saying, how are you? Life is gone. Who said life is gone? It is beginning. Yes? How can you decide life is gone? There are many people, how are you? Pulling on. Are you luggage to pull it? How do you mean? Let's not say that. How are you? Very fine with Swami. How are you doing? Excellent. Can't be better with Swami. That's what Sai devotees should say. Therefore, my friends, believe me or not, if you go to Prasanthalayam, there are 6 or 8 people above 90. Above 90. There are 80 people. There are 20, 25 above 80. Most of them are above 70. How do they work? What energy? They don't take boost or be complex. They have no complex. The complex is Satyasai complex. Satyasai, divine elixir. Satyasai, divine ambrosia. That makes you very, very energetic. So instead of saying my sugar has gone up, attend a bhajan, sugar will come down. My BP has gone up, attend, read some Sai literature, listen to bhajans, BP will be normal. By thinking of sugar, it will increase and increase, further increase, until you are hospitalized. So by thinking of roga, disease, think of yoga, the spiritual practice, connecting with Baba. Therefore, my friends, it is our duty for all elders to read Sai literature, to meditate on Swami, for all youngsters to participate in service activities, for all the children to be sent to Balavikas, and every one of us to be active. Let us feel proud of being a Sai devotee. What is the highest achievement in life? Highest achievement in life is not calculated in terms of past books. No. It is not calculated in time in terms of positions. No. Yes, the value of life lies in being devotee of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba, the highest. Why? Because Victor Kanu from Africa, Victor Kanu served as ambassador all over the world. But he has given me a card. Victor Kanu, Satya Sai Baba devotee, nothing else. Ambassador to different countries, he has not written. He said, being a Sai Baba devotee, that's the highest honor I have. What if the others are trashed, that's all. So my friends, let us congratulate ourselves to be Sai devotees. Let us carry on the touch of Sai message. Let us tap every door and see that all devotees are brought back. Those people who are staying at home, let them join the mainstream because they are losing time. Let us not regret. At a later time, I could have attended, I would have done, it is history. Don't go into the history. Future is mystery. Live in the present. Present is omnipresent. That is Bhagavan, Sri Satya Sai Baba. Thank you, my friends, for your time.
Thank you.
So he's so right. I personally feel, no matter how much I love Baba, but today my battery is 100%. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
And if Prasanthi Nilayam is the main charger, we have 100-hour power bank. There are power banks with 2 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 100, 200, infinite hour power bank with us today. Thank you so much. We are blessed that you are here, sir. So can we have some questions from you? Yeah?
Yes. Questions, please. Right.
Yes.
So, if I know, I'll answer. But I don't know.
So,
Hello. Yeah. Enlightening and lively talk that we had this afternoon. So this is the first talk of Professor Anil Kumar in Delhi, and we are very blessed that he has inaugurated his first talk here at the SSSIC International Center. What we have also done is, over the next 10 days leading up to the Christmas Day, we have organized a talk in every district of Delhi National Capital Region, so that you can benefit from his wisdom, from his learnings of life, from his experiences with Swami that he has had for over 45 years. If somebody can come up and tell the schedule in which all districts this is being done, on which days, and what are the locations, we will just announce that. Please don't miss this opportunity. He's only, I think I was told that this is the longest he has ever been for giving talks in any city or any state. So I think we should take benefit. Let's thank him for that. Dil se taali bajaiye, zara zor se. I think one of the lessons, there are many lessons from this talk this evening, and let me just take the opportunity that, why should we go to Swami in Puttaparthi? Because that is his domain. As much as we go to any other spot of pilgrimage, that is the holy pilgrimage spot for all of us. The centrifugal of our energy force, so to say. Am I correct?
Perfect.
A non-complaining attitude. Let's not have this complaining attitude. We constantly complain within ourselves and express that outside. A non-complaining attitude, if you're a sign devotee, one should never have a complaining attitude towards others. Not to be a doubting Thomas as well. And when he started his talk, I've noted the song that young boys would sing to Swami on the last day of duty. Hame tumse pyar kitna. I think leave that song now. And I think really love him immensely. I think that's something which we should all learn from this evening's talk. And the highest achievement of any Sai devotee, you may have immense sort of grace in achieving ranks and profiles outside But the greatest achievement of any Sai devotee is actually the very fact that he is a devotee of Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. I think that was the greatest message of this evening's talk. And over to all of you to ask your questions to Professor Anil Kumar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Can you feel free? Feel free.
Every year I go for a few months to Uttarpati, and every Sunday I attend your lecture, your talk. What I perceived, during your talks over there is good talk. But what I saw today is very different. The kind of energy I see in you, I never saw it over there.
Greatness of Delhi devotees.
No.
You have pumped up energy into me.
No, but the way you talked, or the way you, well, I am not able to explain, but it was something very, very different than what I saw you there in Puttaparthi. And I was wanting to again be with you on 25th, but I understand you are not there. And maybe on 31st you will be there.
Positively.
So I would like to take some time with you to discuss.
Most welcome.
Yeah, I'm there for the next 1 month. So
people ask me, Anil Kumar, where do you stay? In staff quarters. I give them, wherever you find number of chappals there, where you find the doors open 24 hours, where you find loud laughter and conversation, TV on, it is Anil Kumar's place.
So, familiar with that place, so it will not be difficult for me.
Thank you, sir.
Anywhere, if I ask for Mr. Anil Kumar, somebody will guide me. So I don't have to worry.
Right. Thank you, sir. I would request everybody to ask questions which will help everybody.
What I want to ask, when we go to the villages and motivate the old ladies or the younger ladies, you know, we need some tip which they can catch and just follow Swami. You know, can you just guide us in those lines, how to talk to the newcomers, you know?
How to talk to the newcomers, she's asking.
How to talk to newcomers, very easy.
Yeah.
Very difficult to talk to these old timers. Very difficult. Because they are prejudiced, they are partial, seniority conscious. Some people say, Anil Kumar, you know, I have been a devotee for the last 30 years. So what? There is no service register, there are no increments, there are no promotions. And the other hand, it is an insult to say I am here 25 years without undergoing any change in life. Pride is there, double. Ego, triple. Publicity, multiple. For the last 35 years, divine time wasted. Let us not feel proud of our seniority.
Sir, I would like to elaborate.
Yeah.
What she's saying is, let's say a newcomer who doesn't even have any experience of Sathya Sai Baba wants to come and serve, what should we do?
Yeah, when we interact with them,
yes. What
is the line or the thing you could just give us and think how to just motivate them?
To motivate them to serve?
Sir.
When they don't know about...
Yeah, he doesn't know about the service.
I should start serving. Instead of announcing there will be some service project in the Old Delhi at 8 o'clock, you are supposed to come. While I'll be at home. Let me lead. A leader should lead but not push.
Yeah.
So when I attend necessarily, the other man will come and see and observe. And moreover, my friends, all of you are here. What is a surest sign? Surest sign of a Sai devotee? Do you think we are very happy? Do you think we are all the fortune in life? The greatest gift of Bhagavan to all of us is the spirit of acceptance. Come what may, I continue to be your devotee. I continue to be your devotee. The spirit of acceptance. So, to encourage newcomers, let's talk to them. Supposing some student has come. If I tell him Nagar Sankirtan 4:30, he will never look at your face. And if some youngster comes there, you should wear white dress or else we shall not allow you. Okay, I wear colored dress outside, let us not. Let us not speak of the rules and regulations in the beginning. Let him be slowly introduced to our fold. Understand his mind. Is he interested in music? Yes. You are interested in public speaking? Yes. You are interested in service? Why not? You are interested in administration? Yes. Understand his temperament, his aptitude, and provide him some avenue over here so that we encourage. Slowly baptize him. Slowly discipline him. Not on the face. No. What we do is, oh, you are a devotee? What our people do mistake? Sir, I have come here first time. First time? First time? I have been coming here for the last 40 years. So how does it help you? How does it help me? Loving your fellow comes, sir. Swami came to Padamaskar. Padamaskar. I had 1,000 Padamaskar. Why? So we want to speak our own glory, our own story, our own seniority, our own publicity. That is really prejudicial. Youngsters will never accept it. Let us know. Oh boy, very nice to see you here. Quite handsome. Good. Ah, I see you playing on drums. Good. You seem to be a professional. Oh, you are a very good photographer. Swami will feel proud of you. Let us appreciate them. Let us try to know their talents. Rather telling these are the rules of our 9-point code of conduct to 10 points of discipline. Please keep it to yourself and leave your business. Technique, how do you attract the fellow? Yes, this we have to understand.
Thank you, sir.
Sairam,
sir?
Yeah. Sir, I have a very small question. Since our childhood, we have been listening to one statement that we should do good karmas, we should do bhakti service, so that we can clean the things which we had created in our previous janmas, so that we can go back and merge the God. Because this is what we have been listening, it might be wrong today, but this is what I have been taught, that we should do good karma so that we can get moksha. We should get free from this cycle of birth and death. Sir, my question here is that why that if we have to merge with the God finally, why Bhagwan has created this srishti? First he has parted us from him. We did our karmas and now we are in a way to cleaning them to go back. If this is the cycle to close, why had he started this cycle? And now we are struggling with that. Swami, we should do service. Swami, actually we love you a lot because we want to be with you. But the problem is that we have so many things with us. So this is my question. Why the starting cycle was...
So, sir, you got the question?
Yes, I got it.
Okay.
Okay.
Right, sir. Thank you.
There are certain statements made by you, young man. You use the word merge in God. God is not separate from you to merge. God is not separate from you to merge. What you do is, you concentrate, identify yourself with the Self Supreme beyond time and space. That is identification, artadatmya bhava. It's not merger. Merger happens when two are separate. It's not merger. It's only revelation. It's only recognition. It is only awareness. That's it. Number two, why past karma and all the cycle, life cycle, birth and death? Let's not worry about birth and death. Let us worry about the life now. Birth happened without our knowledge. Death will surely happen someday. Let's not worry about both ends. Let us know the life what it is. Because present is the result of the past and present is the foundation for the future. If you take care of the present, all things will be taken care of. So don't worry. Am I sure? And then about the past karma, you are not wiping out. You cannot. Income tax evasion is different from income tax exemption. Income tax evasion is a crime. Income tax exemption is legal. Suppose you have got so much of such a bad karma, no smile on the face for lifelong, and those that meet me also lose their smile. What am I to do? Attend Nagar Sankirtan, 25% of karma will be wiped out. Life insurance, 20% to income tax exemption. Okay? And then participate in service activity, 30% exemption, ULIP and other things, Provident Fund, 30% exemption. So you will have income tax exemptions, karmic exemptions, but not evasion. and the spirit and the attitude towards life will be altogether different. Thank you.
Thank you very much. May I take this opportunity to ask a question?
Yes. Why
not? I'm going beyond three questions. Sir, many people I meet in the organization today, and I'm talking on behalf of everybody, they say, shh, Mudanalli, don't talk. They say, don't go to Mudanalli, otherwise you can't work in this organization. You know, many people are talking. Let's not, you know, show that we are very nice, we don't talk about Mudanalli, we are only Prasanthi Nilayam, etc. Because people behind the back talk. So why don't you say a few words about this question?
Yes, sir.
Why not?
Let's give him applause. Because he has the guts to put that question. My friends, by asking people not to talk about Mudanalli, they talk more about it. Simple experiment. Tell your children don't go there. They'll certainly go there. Forbidden fruits are very sweet. Therefore, let us not say don't talk. Let us understand falsity there. Let us understand what is really happening there. Let us understand Swami teachings. My friends, when you have got very good friend food at home, why should you go to neighbor's house? Is it necessary to go to neighbor's house when you have got very good food at home? When Lord Baba is with you, do you need to go elsewhere? When you have genuine currency, why do you want fake currency? That example suits today. A lot of currency. So why do you want fake currency? Crores and crores packets are there, come on, box. Do you want the genuine notes? So Swami, let's understand what he said. Bhagavan Baba is a truth, the eternal truth, the cosmic truth. Sachasa Satyam, the truth of truths. He does not believe in any propaganda. He does not ask any funds. He does not tour anywhere. My friends, very interesting is this. Baba said, Swami, it was time when Hira from Japan came with a big plan that Swami should go around the world with all the plan. I am interested because I can follow Swami, see the world, you know. After Hira left, I asked Swami, when are we going? He said, you go, I'll be here. No, Swami, why? Please note this answer. Ants come to the jaggery or the sugar, sugar won't go to the ant. The whole world comes to Swami. Swami, you can't go anywhere. That's what I understand. And Swami talks to you directly. What is the connection between Swami and you? Heart to heart, love to love. There is no mediator here. Mediators are mediocres. Let's not believe, we don't. Do you want anybody to be a mediator between you and your father? You want any mediator between you and your mother? A mediator between you and your wife is very dangerous. So we don't want mediators in life. Why do you want mediators in respect of God? So don't believe in mediators. Don't believe in fake currency. Don't run after people. Baba has given us enough for whole life and for several lives to come. After all, something like this, having earned this merit punyam, let it not be wasted at this stage. Let it not be wasted at this stage. Let it be treasured. Let us enjoy. I don't think that our genuine fellows would go over there unless something they have personal interest over there. We have no personal interest. No. We have only interest in Swami. Swami is interested in you. You are interested in him. That's all. Nobody in between. Am I clear? You want any further clarity?
You can keep the application.
And
Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu.